Here we are again. In this lesson, I will show you how to create this wood ceramic flooring in Cinema 4D Envray. As usual, I have my texture downloaded from SketchUpTexture.com for free, usually. And with this kind of texture, I create my shader. So, first of all, I have set it up my bump by copy the my map and paste it under a filter modifier, reduce the saturation all the way down and set it up the clipping to have quite white map. I show you the difference between before and after these effects of clipping. After doing this, I set it up my bump to 0.2 and I invert the texture. I also activate my specular, set it up to 60% maybe. Oh, sorry, this one all the way down, all the way up to white, and this one to maybe 0.5, sorry. Okay, 0. Maybe 25%. Okay, I want a little bit of reflection glossiness here, because after I control this kind of highlights and glossy material with an heavy ray blend material. After doing this, I copy this texture. This is a simple filter without any clipping, only saturation all the way down to -100, and I copy it under my reflection glossiness and adjust it the value of its power to 0.6 with reflection glossiness of 1. Maybe it's about 0.6 in reflection glossiness here without texture. It's give me more control for realism, because the pixel of my texture control an amount of this glossiness effect. Okay, so I show you this kind of material. Okay, as you can see, I have some highlights here. The bump works well. I don't want a very good, a very intense effects, but only a bit to increase the differences between the parts of my floorings, because this material is good for create floors texture. And with this kind of effect, I have a very matte surface. It could be nice if you want something like this, but in this case I want to create a material more appealing for my interior design process. So I have to add to it a layer of a specular layer of glossiness to make it more gloss. If you do it with the basic settings here, as you can see, I cannot create the right effect. That's because the bump channel interfaced with this specular layer and create some not perfect reflection. So to avoid this problem, I wanna use a V-Ray blend material. This one, simply create Ray Bridge V-Ray blend material, and with simply drag and drop, I put my wood ceramic in my base material. And for the cut material, I create a new V-Ray Advanced material, name it Wood Ceramic Gloss, turn off my diffuse layer and activate only my specular layer with this kind of value. I have created a little bit reddish orangish, as you know here, reflection, because I want to warm up my my material a little bit. I set it up the Fresnel IOR to 1.45 and the reflection glossiness of 0.9. After doing this, I reopen my cut material here, make gloss wood ceramic flooring. It's important to rename properly all your parts of the file and apply my overlay of reflection on the cut material. After doing this, I copy and paste the bump texture here, the filter, in this slot, and set it up the multiplier to 0.5. The blend amount is set it up to RGB 128, that is the standard settings of the material. After doing this, simply I have applied it to my texture. No problem, no worry if you see it here, the white material. It's only the preview of Cinema 4D that's not work very well with V-Ray. But if you start render, you can see the this kind of material. As you can see with this coat layer, I create some warmed I warm up my texture and my shader, and I create a more realistic look for interior visualization, archivics, and so much more. I hope you enjoy this kind of tutorial, and follow me on Instagram, I'm here on YouTube. Bye!